So the other part is with respect to the operating system. Sharing my screen. With respect to operating system, where we have different operating systems, but how these operating systems are all, I mean, before going to Windows and Linux, one kind of operating system, but how an operating system will be based, whether it is a system-to-system connection or whether the same kind of file system can actually access the resources through the network. So these kind of terminology we'll try to see in this. So whenever we talk about the operating system, so it is an operating system that is designed primarily to support the personal computers or the workstations or a system that is connected on a LAN. So even the operating system is also required to access the resources over the network, like printer sharing. Now, let's say we have a printer on the network, then that printer need to be accessed or need to be given some commands to actually execute some sort of commands to take a print. And also we have some common file systems where let's say there is a file stored on a different system that has to be accessed through the share. And there may be some sort of databases which are to be shared across the thing. Now, let's say in an organization, there may be some sort of financial records which can be shared across a team through this database sharing. And also we have this application level of sharing where we can use some of the protocols like FTP or some of the protocols like Samba, where we can use some of applications to actually share these kind of devices. And to the ability to manage those kind of networks and the files that are associated on the disk as well as the network. So this are to be supported by the operating systems. Now, mainly the features of the operating system will be to add, remove, and manage the users on the disk, and also to use the resources on the network, and what kind of data or that is stored on the hardware that is directly attached to the system, and the data on the network, and what is resides the data that is residing on a server that is located in a different part, or the data that is also available over the other kind of network like intranet or the internet, and with respect to the access that is directly connected through the hardware, like there may be some external devices that are connected to the system or to the network, and to protect this data and services located on the system as well as on the networks. And to enable the users to pass the documents or to share these documents to different users or the different users on the system or on the network. So this is how the features will be located, and there may be some different mechanisms like the file printer sharing. We have system management. We have remote access to these kind of applications where we are already seeing during this pandemic that the file system or the operating system can also be taken through the remote kind of or to the users who is located across the network. So using this remote access is also one of the feature, and the network administration where without directly accessing the system, we can take the system, the operating system functionality through the network, and we can administer this operating system. And also we can enable the security features like authentication, the authorization, and what kind of login restrictions we have, where we can have more interaction and discussion during the hardening of this particular system. And basically, when we talk about this operating systems, these are again, we have peer-to-peer, and again, we have client-to-server operating systems. So in peer-to-peer, this network operating systems, we have the kind of mechanisms where the users are allowed to share resources and files located on their computers to be accessed across different computers on the same network. So these are directly connected, or these are considered equal in terms of the kind of connectivity they have, where they can have this ability to use the resources available on the network. But whereas in terms of client server, so this is like the kind of centralized a server which will be issuing the services located at a centralized point to all the different clients that are located across the network. Now, let's say the one example is like the kind of dedicated file server which is located on the network. Now, this file server will be the centralized file server which is located on the network, and all the remaining systems will be the clients who will be accessing this centralized file server. So in this, it's like a client and server architecture where the server will be providing the services and the clients will be receiving the services from the server, so that this operating systems will provide the mechanisms to integrate all these kind of components of the network and allow multiple users to simultaneously share the same resources irrespective of the physical location of the server, right? So this is where the native operating systems also have this inbuilt capability of this network operating systems, so that the data or the resources across the network can also be accessed with respect to the files.